Hey guys, this is Garrett McLaughlin, and today I want to walk you through the four most important areas to include within a successful dynamic warm-up. So what we have up here is kind of a basic list on what I like to include within the dynamic warm-up for running specifically. First thing we have here is neuromuscular activation and control. So can we fire specific muscles that are needed within that running cycle? Some things that tend to become overlooked. There's some areas that become over-dominant within the running cycle. So can we really prep those specific muscles, really connect with those with this mind-body connection to then put into play through some of these other areas. Next thing we have is muscle temp and joint lubrication. Obviously, if you're going to go out there and load the body, run for mile and mile on end, we need to make sure we're warmed up properly. So can we lubricate the joints? Can we loosen up and really warm up these muscles to a degree that when we get out to running, it's not so dreadful for the first few miles, right? I hear so many people that say, hey, I'm so sluggish. I struggle through the first 2 to 3 miles. Well, yeah, I mean, you should. If you're going out there, your body's not ready to then handle the greater demand you're placing upon it, you shouldn't feel great, right? So how do we warm up in an effective way that gets the muscles and the joints ready for running? Next thing we have is locomotion. Again, something that tends to be very overlooked when it comes to running, but this is your skipping, your shuffling, various movements that help really pick up the speed, increase the speed and the velocity of the movement to help improve that neuromuscular aspect of things like the timing and the coordination and the efficiency of the movement. How do we link everything together? Now that we are starting to warm up, how do we link things together that gets us closer to the action of running? Last thing we have, number four here, shock absorption. In my opinion, one of the most overlooked aspects, even more so than locomotion, what we don't realize is that running places 2 to 4 times of your body weight on the system, right? So if you're not including some kind of jumping, landing, plyometrics, and you're just getting out there, you're walking for a few minutes and you're jumping into your run, that's going from very minimal stress in a controlled environment to now going to loading the body a whole lot more. So adding some kind of low-level plyometric drills in there as a stepping stone from that transition point from your dynamic warm-up to your running will help you significantly really feel better those first few minutes and have a more successful run moving forward. So what I want to do today is run you through a sped up version of a dynamic warm-up that you can include within your program before your runs, before your strength training program. It doesn't matter. I mean, this is one of those things that I think will help overall, will really help key in those main muscles needed to be a successful runner to help prep right down the list here in a sequential fashion. So when you get out to your next run, you're going to feel, okay, I feel a lot better. I can start to get into my run rather than, hey, I'm gonna kind of milk it for the first few miles just because my body's not feeling up to it. So stay tuned and let me walk you through that. So now that you learned the four specific areas to include within in the dynamic warm-up and actually a very sequential dynamic warm-up, which I demonstrated, go put that to action. I think what you realize is we don't have to be perfect. Incorporating some of these strategies, even though it is a general dynamic warm-up and it's not specific for one individual person, will really help anyone when it comes to running, especially if you're not including a good dynamic warm-up as it is, if you're just doing some walking or just doing some leg swings before you get going, this will be a great addition to your program. So please allot about 3 to 5 minutes, work on this dynamic warm-up, reach out if you have any questions, and let me know if I can do anything else moving forward to help you see more success with your running. Thank you.